Hello, everybody, and welcome to another episode of So What Did You Think About? I'm your writer, Lord Daiso, and I've got a few more movies to talk about. So let's not waste any time. Let's get started. All right, I guess the first film I'll talk about would have to be Insidious. I like this movie. Honestly, I do. No joke. I found this to be a really good, suspenseful flick. Even if most of the scares were jump scares. Gee, haven't seen that before, Michael. Speaking of which, I felt like this was pretty much a remake of Poltergeist, but in a good way. I actually started to like the characters and the story, and I did find a lot of plot points that were like Poltergeist, but all the flab of it was cut off from it. But that's not all. It not only felt like Poltergeist, but it also felt like Paranormal Activity. Thank God I saw that before this. And Nightmare on Elm Street, the good version. Now, when I saw the trailer, the plot was already explained, but I forgot about it. Woot! No, barely any spoilers! And that it was being directed by James Wang, the director and writer of the first Saw movie and producer of the rest. I felt like this was going to be crap, but I was wrong. I recommend this film to anyone who's a fan of horror films, or to take a date with. In case they get scared, if you know what I mean. Mm-hmm.
Well, you know what time it is!
It's definitely the best horror film that's come out so far since Paranormal Activity 2. Saw that too. Can't wait for the third movie. Though, after all I said, it's not bad, but nothing special. I only said that since it's a good horror film, unlike Red Riding Hood. Oh god, why did I sit through that? My rating for it is going to be 3 mysterious drawings out of 5, equaling up to a 6 out of 10, so it's slightly above average and worth the money. Alright, I guess the next film I'll talk about would have to be Hanna, and there's a lot of good things to say about it. It has good atmosphere, good action, good acting, good directing, a well-done script, and let's not forget, a decent story. Now, this night might not be as long as any of my other reviews, but I am giving this a very positive review. Hanna is the story of a girl who's lived her life in the woods with her father, preparing herself for the impossible. When she's finally prepared, she activates the tracker that her father's had to let the person who's been after him for over a decade to find him. Why he kept it in the first place, I don't know. She then escapes from her captives and goes around the land to meet up with her father again in Berlin, all while making a few friends, and finding the means of survival. And I must admit, for a movie that's an action, adventure, thriller, and suspense movie, it's got some decent comedy in it. But overall, this is the second best film I've seen this year so far. It's up there with Unknown, and I highly recommend this wonderful work. It felt a little lacking a bit on story, but I let it pass, because this really works. My rating for it will be 4.5 arrows to the chest out of 5, resulting in an excellent 9 out of 10. A must see. Better. Now, even though Insidious is out as a good suspenseful horror flick, the best one that's a slasher movie, and no, it's not a remake, but a sequel, it's Scream 4. Now, most of you might be thinking, oh god, yes, please say it's good. You might be saying, oh god, it's back. I thought I was finished it over a decade ago. And some of you might be going, oh god, no, not another god-awful sequel, ah! Well, guess what? It's good. I mean, really good. It's definitely twice as good as Insidious, which I also enjoyed. It was enjoyable to see the cast come back for this movie. By the way, quick note, when I heard this movie was coming out, I had not seen the first Scream movies. So before I saw this, I marathoned through the whole dang trilogy, and then saw it. Plus, I loved Wes Craven's work. He's made a lot of great films like The Hills Have Eyes, Nightmare on Elm Street, and now this franchise. And yes, I hated My Soul to Take. But this made up for it. This shows that Wes Craven still has the right directing talents, but needs improvement on his writing now. But I still enjoyed this film. I loved seeing Courtney Cox on the big screen again, along with damn it, now I can't remember her name. Oh well, but she was that raven-haired hot chick. I think she was my favorite of them. But seeing this movie on the big screen was really well done. It felt like the 90s again. I was so happy. Okay. My rating for Scream 4 will be 4.5 ghost face masks out of 5. Nicely done, 9 out of 10. And tops Hanna, but not Breaking Unknown.
You should have seen the look on your face.
Alright, now we'll get down to the last film of this episode, and that would be Rio. Now, I know you're expecting me to say, enjoy this movie while you can in theaters, it's really worth it. But I'm sorry guys, but this film just didn't satisfy me. It just left a void in me, and I just couldn't come to terms with it. Now, basically, the plot is what it is in the trailer. An endangered bird mate and his master are taken to Rio so the bird can repopulate its race. The birds are then kidnapped, and they try to escape, but are trained, and the guy bird can't fly, so they seek help while they get some friends who are trying to get them together and not kill each other. All while being chased by con men and their bird. I swear to God, this is the whole movie. I'm not kidding. There is barely any character development, next to no real story, and it is just so cliche. I tell you, this type of premise that I described is basically one of the cliches that I hate. Basically, at the end, if the character feels like that, even if he goes back to his master, he feels like he belongs with the one that he's done with on his journey. Now, a couple of the movies have worked with this cliche, like Flushed Away and a couple others that aren't coming to me. God damn it. But you know what I mean. So far, I wouldn't recommend to see this movie, but if you want to, go for it. Though for me, nothing at all. My rating for it is going to be 2 torn feathers out of 5. A sad 4 out of 10. Not the worst movie I've seen all year, but it's just disappointing.
Rio. You did not feel it in here.
Well, that's it for today, folks. And don't miss episode 8 as DragonoftheEastblu does his first movie review, along with myself, for a co-commentary on The Fast and the Furious 5 this weekend. See you then. It was Nev Campbell, goddammit!